me from Jindalee Resources is Lindsay Dudfield. Lindsay, good to see you. How are you?
Yes, I'm very well, Andrew. And yourself?
Doing well, Lindsay. Thanks very much. Look, you've been outlining plans here for the next steps at McDermitt, your lithium project in the States. Just give us a little reminder about some of the recent work that's been done.
Yeah, sure. Look, by way of background for your viewers that aren't familiar with the project, it's located on the Oregon-Nevada border. It's a sediment-hosted lithium deposit, so it's a new style of deposit, an unconventional style, if you like. Very large tonnage, moderate grade. So the potential to have very long mine life and produce lithium chemicals at very low cost. And potentially make the US self-sufficient in lithium, which is a strategic mineral. So we have been working on that project since we acquired, well, in fact, we pegged it in June 2018. And it is the main asset of the company. We published some independent research on our website in February, and I think there was a proactive interview following that. Mm-hmm. And that indicated that if Jindalee is able to achieve the OPEX and CAPEX of our listed peers with similar projects, that there's a very significant potential for a re-rating in Jindalee's share price. In fact, the analyst indicated a share price of north of $3, and we're currently trading mid-30s, 34.5, I think was the last trade. So the key to that, unlocking that value and getting that OPEX down, is metallurgy. So as you've indicated, we announced in June very encouraging results from a sample that was shipped back to Perth, and the met test work there, it looked at two things. It looked at what's called particle size distribution, or where in the sample is the lithium located? And that work was quite clear and showed that the lithium's located in the very fine, or the clay fraction. And by beneficiating the ore, by screening it, so we screen off the coarse material and retain the fine with the lithium in it, we can get a significant upgrade. In fact, about 45% or so increase in the head grade, which is very positive. And the second thing that the test work did, all of the test work to date where we leach the rock to extract the lithium from the rock and put it into solution has used sulfuric acid. And we trialled hydrochloric acid for this test work, and we got very high extraction results. Greater than 97% within 30 minutes, which is very high. I mean, we already had very high results, 97% within 11 hours using sulfuric acid. But this has the potential to offer us this, an alternative processing route. So, yeah, look, we're very happy with those. We've also got ongoing test work in Colorado on a much larger sample, and that's looking at confirming and if you like, finessing the particle size distribution test work, and also looking at screening off or removing carbonate from the ore. Carbonate, as I'm sure you're aware, Andrew, is an acid consumer, and the greatest cost with this style of deposit operating cost is the acid, the cost of acid. So if you can reduce your acid consumption, you drive the cost of production down even further. So that's what we're looking to do. And that's where we see the value. And hopefully we'll be able to achieve similar OPEX to our peers and get the re-rating in the market.
And you're also looking to get out and do some drilling too.
Yes, we've currently, we lodged a permit with the Bureau of Land Management, the BLM, to permit 21 holes at McDermitt. The resource that we announced and the exploration target that we announced, which is very large, at McDermitt, we announced that in November last year, that was based on 13 holes. And so what we're looking to do is drill another 21 holes, as I said. These holes will extend the size of the exploration target. They will also, all going well, assuming they're mineralised, which we've got no doubt that they will be, it'll also expand the size of the resource, which is currently inferred. And we're also drilling some infill holes within that resource, which will convert the inferred resource to indicated status. And once we have a mix of indicated and inferred resources, we can then lodge report a scoping study and lodge it with the ASX. And that will then give investors a bit of a feel for the financials of the project. So, we're all going well, fingers crossed. We're hoping that we'll have the permitting of the holes approved by the end of this month and be looking to drilling late September and have the program finished by the end of October.
Right. How are you finding investor interest in lithium at the moment?
Yeah, well, look, it has been subdued for sure, but and obviously all commodities, in the market we saw a big drop, COVID-related drop in March. Investor sentiment has certainly come back with a vengeance. Obviously, led by gold. Gold's been fantastic. But also, US investors seem to be developing an appetite for lithium stocks. Well, generally speaking, you've got Tesla trading at record highs. There's a lithium ETF, LIT is the code, and that is nearing the highs that were reached late 2017. And there's also emerging projects in the US in particular, sediment-hosted lithium projects, seem to be attracting a bit of investor interest, driven mainly, I understand, by US retail investors. So there's a company called, for example, American Lithium, which is listed on the TSXV. I think the code is LI, which is a great code for a lithium company. They have at 1,000 ppm cutoff grade, which is the lowest grade that we've published for our McDermitt deposit. Their Tonopah deposit has about, I think it was had the numbers here, something like 3.5 million, 3.9 million tonnes in lithium carbonate equivalent, which is a kind of a measure of equalising tonnes and grade over lithium deposits, very common standard. Versus our McDermitt resource at the same cutoff grade is a resource of 7.5 million tonnes. So our deposit, if you like, at the cutoff grade is the resource is almost twice the size of the Tonopah deposit. And plus, we've also around that resource, we've got this pre-resource mineralisation, which is referred to as exploration target range, ETR, of another 15.6 million tonnes of LCE. So, and this is before we've done any more drilling at McDermitt. So look, you say, well, why is that relevant? Clearly your deposit's bigger than theirs, but so what? Lithium America's market capitalization converted back to Australian dollars is $201 million. Jindalee's market capitalization today, $13.4 million. So clearly there's a big disparity in pricing here, and this is what we need to address. And we're looking at ways to address this and see if we can, get US valuations against our McDermitt deposit.
Lindsay, just away from the lithium for a moment, can you give us a couple of words about this this deal with Auroch Minerals?
Yes, well, we've got four tenements, really. One kind of regional project we call Leinster. And we had that farmed out to another company who were primarily interested in the nickel potential of those tenements. And they did a little bit of drilling last year and then handed the tenements back to us. And we were then approached by Auroch, and they're a very technically strong junior explorer. And they hold ground adjacent to one of our Leinster, the tenements making up our Leinster project. And they are keen to test some of the targets that remain untested, nickel targets. They're primarily interested in nickel. But there are also some gold targets on the tenements as well. So we did a deal with them, and the beauty of the deal is that we are free carried through to decision to mine based on a bankable feasibility study. And our free carried interest is 30%. Now, as you, I'm sure you're aware, Andrew, exploring for nickel sulphide deposits can be very expensive. They're like needle in a haystack, steeply plunging. And so you can spend a lot of money before you wind up at a decision to mine. So 30%, without having to put a hand in our pocket until basically it's bankable and you can debt fund your share, is a really valuable asset to have. And I really like the Auroch guys because they're very, as I said, very technically driven, very strong. They've got very good, highly experienced nickel consultants assisting them as well. So we think we're going to get a very good bang for our buck there, and they're going to give it a good run. So
very good. Lindsay, look, importantly, before I let you go, Karen Wellman, tell me more about Karen, your new chief executive, experienced geologist.
Yeah, no, look, we're very, very, very happy to have Karen join us. So we announced that on Monday, that Karen will be coming on as Jindalee's new CEO. She's a very experienced geologist. Her experience covers the whole gamut of the mining cycle from, you know, early stage exploration right through to mining and production. She currently holds a very senior position with Silver Lake Resources, who've been a very successful gold miner in Western Australia. And she is has made significant contributions to their deflector gold copper mine in WA. So we're rapt that she's decided to join Jindalee. I mean, she's young. I mean, you shouldn't discuss a woman's age, but she's at least a couple of decades younger than me. And she's very high energy and very enthusiastic. And we think she's going to add a lot of value to Jindalee, not only obviously with our McDermitt project, which we, as I vindicated, we think has got a lot of upside and we're continuing to advance. But also we've got a very large portfolio of projects in Western Australia prospective for gold and for nickel, and we think she's going to add a lot of value to those assets as well.
And hopefully you can arrange for her to come on and have a chat with me, Lindsay.
Absolutely. Oh, look, she's a lot more photogenic than I am.
Looking forward to it. Lindsay, always great to speak with you. Thanks very much.
Yeah, great. Yeah, thanks, Andrew. Thanks for the chat. Cheers.